So we know that kids get hurt playing sports. And one of the things that I've been on a mission lately is that I am very happy that my son, who's in middle school, plays tackle football. And tackle football was not available in my town, so we had to go to the next town over. Because what I think is a lot of misinformation and people that will rely on one or two stats, and they'll say, oh, tackle football, that's horrible, it's dangerous, concussions, run away, and they move toward other sports. And then you start to do a little research and you find out, huh, they have just as much chance of getting hurt in soccer, cheerleading, hockey. And when I hear things like this, I think, okay, maybe people would think that folks in the program have an agenda. So I thought, well, I wanted to connect with Dr. Don Haas. Now, Dr. Haas is the president of the Pop Warner Football League in West Windsor, where my son participates. And he's got a unique perspective. And he and I were talking the other night. And I said, you got to come on the show and you've got to share your knowledge with the audience, because I think there's a lot of misinformation out there that parents don't understand the truth about football. Dr. Haas, thanks for joining me on New Jersey 101.5. Good morning.
Good morning, Bill. Thank you for having me.
You bet. So we were talking the other night at the banquet as we celebrated our end of season. It was a great season. And as I said, this was my son's first year playing tackle football. He loved it. He'll be back next year. And you were talking about some of the statistics that people point to, and they're not really getting the full picture when it comes to football injuries.
Right. Yeah. So one of the problems is, let me just state that I'm not a neurologist. I'm a cardiologist. My specialty is advanced heart failure and transplant cardiology. But I have a degree in biostatistics. And so with that, I'm able to follow the literature on a variety of topics, but particularly this topic closely, because it's important to understand the statistics and how they're presented. And that's one of the things that gets me so upset, is that we have excellent data and statistics that are published in the medical journals, as recently as this year, mm-hmm. regarding the risk of concussion in football. And that's not what's presented in the media. And in fact, often what we see in the media is a lot of hype or escalation of the stated risk, which really isn't, I think, accurate in the way it's presented. So, the example I used with you, Bill, the other day is how very often when concussion in football is presented, it's done so as a relative risk. So, for example, you are 3 times more likely to have a concussion playing football than you are in wrestling. Mm-hmm. But what actually matters is what the absolute risk is, which is how likely is that event to occur. And we have good data on that published in JAMA this year, 2015, where the rate of concussion is about 1.5 concussions per 1,000 athletic events. So that's the metric that they use to define this.
Okay.
An athletic event is defined as a game or a practice. So when there's, 22 kids out there, playing mm-hmm. a game, that's 22 athletic events. And so there's 1.5 per 1,000 athletic events. And I think that's a much more important way to think about it, mm-hmm. In terms of what the risk is to your kid. If you buy 2 lottery tickets instead of 1, you're 50% more likely to win the lottery.
Right.
But you're still not winning the lottery.
You're still not going to win.
It's all how it's presented.
So,
right?
Doc, how does that compare then to, let's say, soccer? Because everybody says, oh, well, soccer is what you ought to do. It's safe. It's, you don't get the level of concussions and injuries that you sustain in football.
Right.
But how would those numbers compare to soccer?
So there's a lot less. So first of all, it's in some ways it's hard to get a good handle on this. There's better data coming out now than has been published in the past, because there's a much greater focus on identifying concussions, on the sideline of any sport. But generally, the risk of concussion in soccer is probably, in women's soccer, it's higher than it is in men's soccer.
No kidding.
It's consistently shown. In fact, in some studies, women's soccer has a concussion rate that's right up there with football. Men's soccer is typically less, maybe about a third less, but again, there's variability in the studies that you read. Hockey is, and lacrosse are generally up to football. But what's important is a lot of the data that's been presented historically is really almost antiquated in some sense, because there's a lot of initiatives that are going on across the country, I think in large part to Pop Warner and also the CDC in identifying concussions early and you know, make it, see, from my point of view as a parent, right? So I played football. It was a tremendously positive influence in my life and something that I wanted my son to experience. But I'm a parent, right?
Right.
So I'm letting my son play football. And I think the crucial thing is that there is the risk of concussion in any sport that's out there. You
right.
can't eliminate risk. And, you know, I mean, if you want to talk about non-contact sports, that's a separate story. But if you talk about football or hockey or wrestling or soccer, you know, all of the basketball, all of these
right.
sports have an inherent concussion risk, which, thankfully, for all of these sports, in absolute terms, is actually quite low and quite reassuring. The real issue is identifying that concussion early. And, you know, Bill, as you know, our program, we are absolutely
right.
determined to make sure that all of our coaches have proper training, sideline training, to make sure that they identify concussion. And look, at the end of the day, these kids aren't going to the pros, right? So we pull them off the field if there's any suspicion
right.
that there's a concussion. So, you know, you pull them off the field. So, you know, but the, in terms of, you know, what the biggest thing that's, I think, changing the game is heads up tackling. Heads up tackling is a
right.
technique that's, you know, mandatory in Pop Warner. Our program is certified.
Doc, let me just ask you real quick. Can you hang on the line with me? I've got to take a quick break for traffic
sure.
and weather, but I want to ask you about what you tell parents directly who say you're crazy to let your kid play tackle football. So
I tell them that the risk of concussion is present in any sport. And when you look at the absolute risk, not the relative risk like we talked about before the break,
mm-hmm.
but the actual risk of concussion in all of those sports is actually pretty similar. And the most important thing is not so much, in my view anyway, the risk of whether or not that first concussion can occur, because it can in any sport. And in fact, if you talk to players and parents on all of those other teams, I guarantee you, you're going to hear about a concussion that occurred.
Right.
It's how that team handles the concussion. It's how that team is aware of that first concussion and how they respond to it. And I'm extremely proud of our program and I think the efforts of Pop Warner in general and an awareness about concussion, how to diagnose it, and making, you know, none of our kids come back until they've been cleared by a physician,
mm-hmm.
period. And we have a very, very low threshold to pull them off of the field. But I think, you know, equally as important is what we're doing to prevent concussions. Heads-up tackling is a technique now that's you know, it's mandatory training for Pop Warner coaches.
Yeah.
And it's a technique that involves keeping the head out of tackles and out of blocking.
Right, you were talking about the heads-up tackling.
Correct, right. And that's something that, you know, I'm 46, and this was not a part of my
right.
experience growing up. And that's had, you know, early data coming in. It's relatively new, but there was a study that followed players, about 2,000 kids, youth football, over a couple of seasons, and it cut the concussion rate by a third, you know, which is tremendous, you know, and it's all about that. And to that point, I think, you know, there's also a discussion about, you know, when should tackle football start, you know, before high school or after high school. And it's one of the arguments for starting football earlier is exactly that, is that you learn how to tackle properly at an early age, which, you know, furthers the you know, reduction of the concussion risk. Last week, I think, or the week before, the American Academy of Pediatrics came out and looking specifically at this issue, and you know they did not say that we should stop
mm-hmm.
tackle football, you know, at the youth level, and you know, for a variety of reasons. But there's other things that we do. You know, we limit the amount of contact that we have during practice. You know, depending on
right.
the study, about half of concussions occur in practice, so that's something that we can, you know, clearly cut back on. You know, so there's and I think in some way the overstated risk of football injury has
yeah.
drawn a microscope on the sport, which has led to a lot of the positive, you know, safety measures
mm-hmm.
that we take now. But I think, you know, in terms of coaching and awareness for injury, there's no sport like football, because we're so much, you know, in tune with what we need to be doing for our kids.
Yeah. All right, Dr. Haas, thank you very much. I really appreciate you putting that medical perspective on it. And just what you said, to hear it from you as a medical professional, very different than just hearing it from me. I have said this all along, that I wanted my son to play before high school. I did not want his first experience in tackle football to be as a freshman in high school, because it just logically, it seemed that he ought to learn the game first. And I appreciate that you've put some medical perspective on that. Thanks for joining me on New Jersey 101.5.
Thanks,
appreciate
Bill.
Your time. You bet. All right, so there you have it. There is a lot of misinformation out there. And here's the bottom line. No one, including Dr. Haas, including the parents that are involved in Pop Warner, not me or anyone that I know on our in our program, will tell you that there are no risks. You know, this idea that we can be a risk-averse society isn't the reality. The reality is there are risks in everything you do, whether it's riding a bike or walking to school or driving your car. I mean, there are so many risks that the question is, how do you mitigate against those risks and how do you keep the kids as safe as you can while still learning the fundamentals of what is a great American game? So I hope that helps shed some light on some of the misinformation out there. Pretty much the bottom line is tackle football, soccer, hockey, cheerleading, wrestling, all in a very similar category of risk. It's about the coaching. It's about the technique. It's about being smart about it and getting the facts instead of being afraid from emotion.